My name is Michael Cowles. I'm the president of the Edsel Owners Club, and I've always owned an Edsel. My first car was purchased in 1968 for $150. Edsels were not very popular during their time when they came out in September 1957. Since then, they've become popular because it was sort of the loser of the Ford Motor Company. When they introduced the Edsel back in 1957, the people were expecting something really spectacular. And what actually turned out to be was a glorified Ford or a Mercury. So the Pacer came with the Ford chassis, which the Ranger and the Pacer came. And then that was considered their lower end model and the smaller of the Edsels. Their more deluxe Edsel was the Corsair and the Citation. And those were considered like the premium Edsel that you could purchase. What happened with Edsel was during the period that these were made, Ford Motor Company was trying to popularize their line of cars, because at the time they only had Ford, Mercury, and Lincoln, and they decided that they needed something to compete with General Motors, which had about 7 or 8 different models of cars, Pontiacs, Oldsmobiles, and Chevrolets and Buicks. And the Chrysler, of course, had their Plymouth and their Imperials, and they had all these different models. So with the Edsel, what they decided to do is they were going to have the Ford, the Mercury, and the Lincoln, and then they were going to put in the Edsel Ranger Pacer to go between the Ford and the Mercury, and then the Corsair and the Citation, which was going to go between the Mercury and the Lincoln. So they would have 5 different cars to compete with all these other cars that the other manufacturers were doing at the time. Overall, the Edsel became very controversial because of its horse collar grille. And that's something that we use today as a sort of friendly remark of the front end of the car. Again, Roy Brown, who was the designer of the car, decided he wanted something that would show a classic front end like the Packards had and the Buicks and the Oldsmobiles and the Cadillacs from the 30s. And as the car was introduced back in 1957, even though this is a 58 model year, people generally liked the car. They thought it was pretty neat looking. But then when the marketing people decided that it didn't really fit with the rest of the cars from this period of time, then the slanderous remarks sort of came out. And people said, well, it looked like an Oldsmobile sucking a lemon. It was odd looking. It was basically a glorified Ford with some extra gizmos on it. And as a result, it became unfavorable, and people parked their cars, their Edsels, behind the barn and in their garage, and then they became the laughing stock of everybody who had jokes on TV and through the public. Over the years, the Edsel has become popular because of its loser sort of recognition that people gave it. They only made the Edsel for 3 years, 1958, which is the purest design by Roy Brown and his team, and 59 has sort of integrated the front end horse collar and sort of toned it down. But by 1960, they only made 2,846 cars, and the rarest is the convertible, of which some have been known to sell for over $150,000. So this is basically the story of the Edsel, and I'm president of the Edsel Owners Club, and it's fun to own them. I like them very much. They've become very popular. The prices are going up very fast on them, since the Chevrolets, the 57 Chevrolet coupes and convertibles are now selling for $75,000, $80,000 in fully restored condition. Edsels are quickly picking up with this. People like them because of their styling and because of their uniqueness and because of their beautiful color combinations. This one is painted in snow white and ice green, and the interior has the original cloth in it that was redone about 6 months ago. But the car is basically original, and we enjoy driving it very much.